In this episode, I'm going to show you a really cool trick using expression controls and a very unique method of quickly selecting pre-comped assets. This is one of those examples where thinking outside the box really comes in handy. Not to mention, all of my fellow AE nerds out there will love how this is put together. This technique also works great for making characters talk using pre-comped mouth movements, as well as a number of other useful applications. As always, there are a ton of shortcuts you'll learn along the way. Please like, comment, and share this video. Subscribe for notifications. Join our channel for just $4.99 a month. If you find my content helpful, you can show us your appreciation using the links in the description below. Check out our affiliates, Envato Elements and AE Juice, for amazing deals on all of your motion graphic and animation needs. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's start a new composition. The main thing here is your frame rate. So we're going to reference this frame rate later on. So whatever frame rate you use here, we'll need to use in another comp. For now, I'm just going to use 30 frames per second. The duration doesn't matter because that really depends on how many elements you'll be switching between. So let's just choose OK. Okay, so now under effects and presets, we have our animation presets. Under user presets, I've created a folder for social media icons. And if you've joined my channel, there's actually a link to these. So I made these social media icons out of shape layers. So that way I could save them as animation presets and bring them back in just by choosing these from our effects and presets panel. So I'm just going to double click Facebook. I'll make sure I click away and then choose Instagram and then click away. And the main reason why, I'll show you real quick. So click LinkedIn there. If I still have this layer selected, whenever I go to Pinterest, it's going to overwrite that. So you want to make sure you're clicking away. Pinterest, Snapchat, Twitter, and YouTube. Okay, and actually we want this to be centered up, so that should be centered like that. Let's take all of these layers and then Option or Alt right bracket to bring them all over. That way they're just one frame long, and then choose from top to bottom. Right click, Keyframe Assistant, Sequence Layers, and this will spread them out one frame apart. So whenever you use sequence layers, it will stack them however many frames long each layer is. So okay, and as you can see, they're one frame apart each. So now if we go to this last shape layer here and hit O to go to the end, and then N to bring over our handle, right click and trim comp to work area. So this is all we want right here. So these seven icons, let's just move all these over. So I'm going to select all of these and then move this over, and then we're going to create some new text at YouTube. And I'm going to get this about the same size as our icon here. So I'm going to make sure this is centered. So the way we do that is, hold on, Command and double click our pan around tool. And you can see our anchor point goes right to the center, and make this 540. And you want to make sure you have your paragraph left justified. Enable our snapping. So we have our snapping enabled right here. Grab our pan around tool. And then if we go to our anchor point on YouTube, you can actually pull this to the left and it will snap right here to this node. So that way, as we size this, it will size up from where our anchor point is. Let's just pull this over to the left. Let's go to this second icon here, and we want to split this layer. So that's Command-Shift-D, and then just change this to at Twitter. Go to the next frame, split Command-Shift-D, at Snapchat. Go to the next one, at Pinterest, at LinkedIn. Normally, what you would be doing is putting in your actual handle here. So I'm just typing in the social media icon that we're actually affecting here. So at Facebook. Okay, and then one more thing I want to do is put this on a bar. Let's right click, new shape layer, and actually bring this down to the bottom. And we want to create a rectangle and give that rectangle a fill. Change this fill to like a black. Now you can't see it against our background here. If you Command K, you can actually change your background color. So just click this black. And maybe I'll make it, you know, something like a gray, so that way we can just see what we're doing. Okay, and I'm just going to shape this rectangle path here, so that way it covers our YouTube. Click Y to bring up your pan around tool, and since we still have snapping enabled, I'm going to pulse over to the far left, so that way it's going to snap to this node right here on our shape layer. Click S on this bottom shape layer, and actually I'm going to go ahead and rename this just to bar, so that way we can see it, and maybe change the color, so that way we know this is something special. And on our scale, let's unconstrain this. And then holding down Command, let's just start to tweak this X scale. So that way it just kind of goes around our YouTube. And again, we're going to do this for all of these icons. So S for scale, and bring this over like that. I'm going to split that, S for scale. make that about like that. And again, I'm holding down Command while I'm scrubbing through our scale settings. So that way you have more control. So see, if you can see the percentages is going by tenths. Okay, and then, so let's just continue here. As for scale, I want to bring this over, split that layer. And then the last one as for scale, and we want to size it like that. Okay, so this is exactly what we want for our social media bar. And actually, let's Command K, and I want to rename this to social media. So that way we know what this is. So now let's grab our social media comp here. I'm going to drag it into a new comp. And then Command K to rename this, and we're going to call this final. And then let's change our duration to 10 seconds. So now if we pull out, we can see that our pre-comp here only goes to these six or seven frames that we've created. Now let's bring up S for scale and just scale this down a little bit. Maybe pull the position. Command T to bring up your text. I'm just going to put my name here, so Jeff Knight. Just kind of size this a little bit so that way it's lined up a little bit better. So this is basically going to be our lower third here, just a very, very basic lower third. But the whole point of this tutorial is I'm going to show you how you can easily switch between these handles here. And now this technique can be used for any number of things. I did a character animation tutorial a while back. It was like a 5-part series where I showed you how you can make a character talk. So this technique can actually be used for that as well. And actually, I think this technique will be a lot more efficient. So let's just add in a few things here. So we want to right click on this layer, go to time, enable time remapping, stretch this all the way out. And then let's right click on this first keyframe and just toggle that to a hold keyframe and then get rid of this second keyframe. Okay, so with that layer selected, we want to go to Effect, Expression Controls, Slider Control. And now we want to Option Right click our time remap and use this pick whip here. This is your expression pick whip up to the slider. Now let's right click New Shape Layer and we want to rename this to Choose. So this is actually what we're going to be using to choose which one of these social media icon handles we'll be using. On the choose layer, hit R to bring up your rotation. So now we need to open up our effects here and let's pick whip our slider control up to our rotation. The shortcut on your number pad for plus and minus affects rotation. So if you have any layer selected, so like I'm just going to select Jeff Knight. If I hit plus, as you can see, it's starting to rotate this. Hit minus, it goes back the other direction. So plus or minus on the number pad is a shortcut for increasing and decreasing rotation by 1 degree. So since we've pick-whipped our slider up to our rotation, the thing we want to make happen is we want to advance through our social media handles. There's one other thing we have to do though. Let's open up our slider control for this expression here. Remember I said that it's very important that you pay attention to your frame rate divided by whatever frame rate you're using. So 30 in our situation here. So Command K, we can see we're at 30 frames. So now if we select choose and hit plus, we can see it advances through each one, which is really cool. Hit minus, it goes back the other direction. So now you need to make sure you're starting on rotation at 0 degrees. If it minus here, it goes to -1, we get no results. So this needs to go from 0 up to, we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The last one is Facebook. So if I hit plus again, it's going to disappear because we're only using those 7 actual frames. Okay, so now let's just add a little bit of animation to this. So let's open up our Jeff Knight layer. I'm going to add in a position text animator. Open up our range selector. Let's change the square to ramp up. And then our ease low to 100%. And then we want to animate this using our offset. So we'll go -100 up to 100. And then we need to set our position on our text animator. We'll say maybe 150. So what we get is this, and I don't want to go by character. I want to go by word. So just change this based on the word. Go beyond this second keyframe here and Command Shift N to add in a new mask. As you can see, it popped on right there. Or if you want to, you can always grab your selector, right click on the layer, mask, new mask. Okay, and watch that play back. We can see how it reveals like that. And then let's select our social media pre-comp here. Go to Effect. Transition, linear wipe. Let's make our wipe angle -90. And let me see. So we start at 100. Let's put our first keyframe at the beginning of our animation for 100%. You to bring up our keyframe. Shift page down twice. And this make this value 0. And then feather this about 20%. I'm going to right click on this last keyframe here. Keyframe assistant, easy ease in. Go to our graph editor and pull that handle all the way to the left. And so just very, very basic. I'm not trying to do anything special with this lower third, just something to give a little bit of movement. But so say like if you wanted to render this out with your Twitter handle and then you needed to render out another one super quick and you wanted Facebook, for example, just plus and minus. I'm just clicking the plus and minus on my number keypad to Facebook. You got that instantaneously and then whatever other handle you want. You can also keyframe these. So say let's put a keyframe for rotation right here and then maybe go, we'll say 20 frames and then hit minus, go down to Twitter. And then you want to make sure that you select these, toggle those to hold keyframes so that way they won't change until they get to the actual keyframe there. And watch that play back. So first we have Pinterest, then Twitter. You know, let's extend this out a little bit. We can actually maybe go down to YouTube, go a little bit further, go down to Instagram. There are a number of instances that you can use this technique. It's a super cool little nerdy trick, and that's one of the things that kind of turned me on to it. I always like learning these new cool ways of doing things. I'm going to hit EE to bring up our expressions. And the main thing to remember from this is on this expression from your slider control, you divide it by the frame rate of your comp. And you want to make sure that this comp is the same frame rate as your pre-comp for your social media icons. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds in virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.